the staff do get very, very close to the residents, and they really did, I think, have an underappreciated burden of grief that contributed over time to, you know, kind of compassion fatigue and burnout, because it wasn't really part of the tradition and culture in long-term care to really support the staff when a resident dies. This is part of the tradition in hospice, but again, with the changing role of long-term care, that hasn't really been embedded in the culture. So personal support workers talked about the importance of having sort of a post-death debriefing where they could remember the resident, where they could support each other, you know, kind of have the positive kinds of feelings about that resident. And we worked with them to sort of both get sort of support and permission from the management for this to happen, because they're so busy. They didn't really feel that if we take 15 minutes and do this to help ourselves regroup to go back and still provide care to the next resident, like, we think we're going to get in trouble. And so now it's been, you know, kind of approved as a very important part of workplace wellness. And I think from a psychological point of view, that's very much the case. And they're very good at supporting each other, but we've been able to teach them a little bit about post-traumatic stress and compassion fatigue, and help them recognize a few signs and symptoms of where a colleague may be in trouble. So, you know, we've tried to really support them in that way with the post-death debriefings. And I think that's something that all long-term care homes need to incorporate into their workplace wellness strategies.